This is Tess, female ball python. She's about 11 months old. Here she's getting ready to swallow a mouse she freshly killed. She's getting the rest of her body's inside the box, so you can't really see it, but she's gotten so big. You know, when I first got her, she used to fit in the palm of my hand, one hand. Now she's huge. I need two hands to hold her, and she's bigger than that even. So I think in the next couple months, I'm going to try to see if she'll take a rat. Because I noticed the mice are kind of too small for her. She'll swallow it down, and she comes out looking like she's looking for another one. I just fed her about 3 days ago, another mouse. So I noticed that she's so thick that they say that you could feed a snake something equivalent to the thickest part of their body, that they can swallow that. So this mouse, like, next to her fast part of the body, I mean, it's like nothing. So I'm going to try upgrading her to rats. I did try that once before, but it might have been premature. She didn't take it. I don't know if it smelled different to her. I don't know if she just realized it was too big for her. So she made no attempt to take it. So I had to go out of my way to kill it, and she still wouldn't take it. So that was a flop. So we'll try that again in a couple of months. Maybe the time she's about a year, which would be, I think, about September. And see how she makes out. She does this strange thing where she kills the mouse. She's always done this. And then she goes, like, back in the house, looks around or whatever she does. Then she comes back out and finishes eating it. That's just her style. I think it was once or twice where she swallowed it right down, but usually she goes through this routine. I don't know if it's something physiological she has to prep for swallowing the whole thing or how that works. But here she goes complete back into the house. She looks around, she sniffs around. She sniffs the mouse again. And before you know it, she goes for the head and swallows it. And usually nowadays she looks around like for another one. But I don't want to buy two at once because I don't know if I'm going to get stuck with the other one. I myself happen to be allergic to mouse and rat and all that kind of stuff, urine, so I don't like having them around. Again, this is Tess. She's about 11 months old. Not a baby anymore, but I'm not sure they're considered juvenile at this stage. She's about, when I got her, she was 18 inches long, roughly. Now she's actually twice that long. She's 3 feet long. And I think they grow up to a maximum of 4 or 5 feet, so she's pretty close to it. She's getting there. I mean, I feed her pretty well, so she's probably going faster than if you just fed them, I guess, a couple times a month. I guess I'm sort of in tune with her body language, so when she comes out and does certain things, or after she sheds, I know that she wants to eat. And she just shed last week, and I gave her mouse the day after she shed, took it. This is like 3 days later, I think, maybe four. My apologies. I think on this video, I forgot to set the camera when she first grabbed it. But, I mean, she is so motivated to eat that when I put a mouse in there, usually with the box, the last time I put a mouse in there, she grabbed it like within 4 seconds. I mean, I've seen other snakes on YouTube, and you know, I mean, they're pretty quick. Some of them take forever, it seems like. But this one has gotten so efficient at it. So sometimes I think of getting another one, but then it might be a hassle how you feed them. Because if they both grab the same mouse and so forth, it can get complicated. I'd have to section off the aquarium maybe. But I just moved into this 55 gallon last week. She used to be in a 20 gallon. So I gave up my fish for her. I guess the fish are a lot more trouble to keep, actually. Although they're pretty to look at. But, you know, a lot of people are scared of snakes, or they don't like snakes, but it's almost an ideal pet. They don't make any noise. They, they don't crap on your rug. You don't have to walk them. Obviously, they're not cute and fluffy like a dog or something like that, but, you know, they're not for everybody, I guess. But it's a nice pet. They're interesting. I mean, animal has no legs, no wings, no arms, no feet, no hooves, and somehow has been around for millions of years. That's pretty impressive. I mean, it can climb trees, it can kill, it can swim. I find all that pretty amazing with an animal that has no appendages. And there she is. That's what she does after she swallows. She stretches out. She finishes pushing the mouse down to her stomach. She yawns to reset her jaws. And now she's probably ready for a nap. I noticed she functions a lot better closer to 90 degrees. When I first got her, I used to keep about 80, 85. But she's actually, when I first got her, she was kind of reluctant to eat, I guess, because I didn't keep her warm enough. But once I rose the temperature, now she's like just great at it. Now see how she's looking around like for another one? So maybe that was like a snack for her.